U.S. officials today filled in more of the picture on how Osama bin Laden met his end. New facts and images emerged 48 hours after he died at the hands of U.S. commandos. Jeffrey Brown begins our coverage.
Curious crowds gathered outside Osama bin Laden's compound in Pakistan today to see where the terror leader had lived and died. There and elsewhere this day, some of the curiosity focused on the hard evidence of his death. In Washington, White House spokesman Jay Carney said no decision had been made on whether to release photos of bin Laden's burial or of the al-Qaeda leader's remains.
It's fair to say that it's a gruesome photograph.
Carney alluded indirectly to reports that bin Laden was shot above the left eye and part of his skull was blown off.
There are sensitivities here in terms of the appropriateness of releasing photographs of Osama bin Laden and in the aftermath of this firefight, and we're making an evaluation about the need to do that because of the sensitivities involved.
In turn, a spokesman for the Afghan Taliban insisted the U.S. had not released, quote, convincing evidence that bin Laden really was dead. Meanwhile, there was more information on the Sunday night raid by Navy SEALs. Officials said they swept the heavily fortified compound in Abbottabad, hunting the target, codenamed Geronimo. They said bin Laden was not armed, but did, quote, resist capture. There were also photos of the charred wreckage of a U.S. Black Hawk helicopter that had landed hard in the bin Laden compound after suffering mechanical failure. The SEALs destroyed it as they left the mansion with bin Laden's body. In addition, the commandos took away what some officials described as a motherlode of intelligence, thought to include computer hard drives, DVDs, and documents, all now being combed for clues to future al-Qaeda strikes. At a U.S. House oversight hearing, Attorney General Eric Holder cautioned that al-Qaeda was still a threat to be countered.
Although we can all be proud of Sunday's successful operation, and we can all be encouraged by the way that thousands of Americans have joined together at this defining moment in our fight against terrorism, we cannot become complacent. The fight is far from over.
Holder also said the operation, authorized Friday morning by President Obama, met all legal requirements.
I think that the acts that we took were both lawful, legitimate, and appropriate in every way.
Reaction also continued around the world from this man on a Tehran street.
I don't think that killing bin Laden will have a serious positive effect in the region. They have enough men to replace him. I can't believe they had just one guy. They will find other talents and use new people.
And from Iraq, where a lawmaker expressed hopes that al-Qaeda's days were numbered.
In the recent years, we, the Iraqi people, were the victim of this terrorist organization. The death of bin Laden has certainly influenced the morale of this group and its members. We hope that this will be the beginning of the end of this terror organization.
Outside Atocha station in central Madrid, which was bombed in 2004, travelers worried about what would come next.
I think that they are going to do something. They are not going to leave it like this.
Now there is more possibility of attacks. And because there is a possibility, security does need to be tightened. There needs to be more vigilance.
To the north, in Brussels, an airport official said more was being done.
For the moment, I think that we will certainly have national security additional measures. I don't think at European level. It's very difficult to be more safe at European level. We'll look at different, at local level, what could be the special threat.
And in the U.S., visible security measures were in place at many airport and train stations and other possible targets.